This is BIPOLAR SUNSHINE and this is KVM Magazine.
Let's take a ride, let's get inflated on this air balloon. Look at those people, they ain't with us, they ain't off the fumes. We're pushing on, we're pushing on, we're pushing on. See, down there ain't the type of place I wanna settle down. I'd rather be lifted, chasing marshmallows, living off the ground. We're pushing on, we're pushing on, we're pushing on.
BIPOLAR SUNSHINE is myself, but I work with a collective of people that, you know, we work around something. I'm just trying to say, you know, we're always searching for that place or that being or that person who can come into your space and, you know, take you for who you are. And Deckchairs On The Moon is separating yourself from others, but trying to find the ones who want to follow you, to come with you. And that could either be in a relationship scenario or just in a life scenario, on your friend scenario, to be perfectly honest. And that's how cults and things are formed, is when people choose to all go in a certain direction. So Deckchairs On The Moon is like my stand towards that. And it's just a name, and it's a working title that we're all working towards. When I play live, I bring three other people involved when we play live. I work closely with this guy called Jazz Purple, who produces, and, you know, that's what all these elements help to create the BIPOLAR SUNSHINE sound. But the whole BIPOLAR SUNSHINE ethos is from myself.
And is this only wishful thinking?
Fraser's good, man. Fraser's a safe guy as well. Working with Fraser was good, man. Like, every time we go with Fraser, we're always like coming out with like a massive tune. So working with Fraser's great, man. He's got a great team there of people that he works with as well. Oh, Kid Happy is a safe guy, man. Like, I made some good songs with him. He's proper safe, man. He's like, you know, talented guy. And just fun, man. Like, when people are just down to earth, the session goes really easy and you create something great. And he's a great guy, so. Yeah, like I live with Jazz Purple, do you know what I mean? Me and him are like brothers in this game, so, you know, whatever I do, he does, and vice versa, so. But Jazz Purple to me is the ultimate, like, regarding producer and just being a general music mogul mentality guy. Then he's a great person to have around and inspiration, so he's very inspiring to work with artists. I've done videos before that I've scrapped because, you know, they didn't let me have input on it and I didn't like it, so we changed it. This video we did with a guy called Kareem. I've done amazing director, worked with some great people that he's got working with him. And we're just joint forces. When people are on the same wavelength, the idea is always going to come out a lot more different than what everyone else. Some people would class the videos a bit strange and a bit odd, but, you know, it's a talking point. It needs no point having a video with no talking point. There's too many videos out there that are just throw over your head. Definitely not the Queen. I say Rihanna, man, because Rihanna seems... Beyonce is taken and Rihanna's not, so I could just kind of just, you know, inspect. Ooh. Probably. Oh my, That's a tough one. Well, that's a tough one. I say Michael Jackson, but it's either Michael Jackson or Bob Marley. Someone like that. I probably won't talk to them. I think before their time signals, like, they won't have their time. So I wouldn't say they're before. I'd say very future thinking. I'd say someone like, I think, I'd say King Cruel. I think he's very forward thinking and he's an angle of how he's trying to make music. I wouldn't say it's, I'd say he is for now, but he's very forward thinking and I quite like it. Probably a Mercedes SLS, the McLaren Barabbas version, straight out there because it just looks so sick, powerful. You can only fit two people in it because, you know, you're just trying to get on that set and ride by yourself with one other person. And this is pure slip, man. The chassis is crazy. You all have the right emotive sentiment. Genres just get thrown in there, so we're talking from soul to R&B to hip hop to garage to dance to house to deep house to indie. Basically, the whole they're my main ones that I draw from. Also, you know, you put a little bit of. You put a throw a little Karen Carpenter in there. You throw a little bit of Bob Marley in there. You throw some Outkast in there just to go around the sides and trimmings and early Pharrell moments and early Ye moments. And just like straight cultural movement sound, cultural sounding songs. Songs that like defined an era, do you know what I mean? That like when you hear certain songs like from Subtract that they did with Sanford, they were like, to me, they signify the time where we were at. So. It's about finding those type of records, and I'm out for key big records. That's what I enjoy, the ones that really like shape and change things. So they're the type of things I put in there. I'll throw Prince in there, man. I'd probably, to make it fun, I'd probably just go with Rihanna. So I think after 48 days, I probably could talk around to do whatever I wanted. So we'll do a bit of music, you know. And that's kind of like that's kind of how that would work. Oh, I'd say Kendrick's is much more lyrical, but Drake has just got like a ridiculous flow. He felt ridiculous. I'm a massive Nas fan, but every time I hear a Jay-Z record and he spits, I'm just like, he's fire, so I'm gonna go with Nas. Hello, hell. Andre 3000. Beyonce. Adele. Usher.